Coast Daylight, the pride of the Southern Pacific Railroad. Ever since its inaugural run on March 21st, 1937, the train has met the passengers' demand for speed, comfort, and of course, eye appeal with great success. Many people prefer to call it the most beautiful train in the world. Running from San Francisco to Los Angeles, passengers would get a chance to see the glorious Pacific Ocean as the daylight traveled along the famed coastline. An interesting fact about the train, that it would always receive the newest and latest equipment, making it state-of-the-art and top of the line. Usually, when the Coast Daylight is re-equipped, the old equipment is passed down to the railroad's other passenger trains, such as the San Juan Keen Daylight or the Shasta Daylight. Back in December 1951, the train was re-equipped once again in preparation for the holiday season. The old equipment was passed down to the Bucketliner Daylight. Both Luke and Tyler were thrilled when they heard the news and couldn't wait to receive the new train. Luke was the most excited. In fact, he began bragging to the other engines. It was one December morning. He was telling Larry and Daniel the time he operated the train.
Yes, there's nothing like running from San Francisco to LA on the coastline. You could just feel the ocean breeze, smell the air, and on those good days, you could see the islands out there. Santa Cruz, Santa Rosa, even a Canacapa Island.
Hate to burst your boiler, Luke, but I despise the coastline routes.
What?
Yeah, staring at the ocean makes me feel sick to my firebox. I say Donner Pass in the Sierras is definitely the best scenic route. Winter time is the best time to see the mountains.
Yeah, especially when being trapped in an avalanche.
Hey, shut up, will ya? It was only one time.
You're both wrong. Traveling through Alaska is more picture perfect than the Sierras or the coastline. During late nights, you can see the great aurora borealis.
The what?
The northern lights.
Wait, you've been to Alaska?
Okay, we're getting off topic. The fact is, the coastline route is better than any other line. End of conference.
Luke is right. Three of you, back to work, right now. Break time's over. Luke, before you leave, can I talk with you and your crew alone, please? Of course, sir.
Now what did we do?
Now, I know this is kind of a short notice, plus with the holiday rush coming around, but I need your three's help.
Help? With what?
Looks like the Los Angeles Yard Dispatcher is having trouble with one of their engines.
You mean like breaking down troubles, sir?
No, nothing like that. The engine is, what I heard, a stuck-up. I was told that she doesn't want to work and is so stubborn. Not even her crew can't even get her to work at all. So the dispatcher will be sending her here to help us out.
Let me guess. You want us to help the crew out to get this engine off her lazy butt and start working again.
You read me well like a book. Oh, why now, sir? You know this isn't a good time to be dealing with this type of nonsense.
I know that, Luke. I even tried to explain that to the dispatcher. But you know how those damn city folks are. Plus, with my... If I didn't, then they would... It's a long story. Look, all you just have to do is take her out to Salt Lake City with the Bucketliner Daylight. Help her crew and turn her into a proper working engine. That's all.
Easier said than done, I say, sir.
Okay, then. How about this? I'll double your salaries. Both of you. What do you think?
Well, let us just do some thinking.
Deal.
What?
Brilliant. The new engine will arrive with Tyler and the Bucketliner Daylight tomorrow. Oh, here's your work orders for today. Now then, I must be off. Have a good day, you three.
Mark, try not to take offense to this, but for just once, could you shut your big yap?
Come on, Mr. B. With our salary doubled, we can easily pay for the rent.
Do I even need to be reminded about the damn rent?
The next morning, Luke was on the service track, getting ready to start the day.
That must be Tyler with the new train.
And the new engine.
Okay, guys. Luke's all set and ready to go.
Thanks again, Nigel.
scrap.
These cars are stainless steel. Nice.
Not too shabby. What do you think, Luke? You fine pulling these cars from now on?
Yeah, of course.
All right then, let's go ahead and meet this new engine.
Once Luke stopped next to the new engine, he and his crew were in great shock. It's... my sister? It's my sister?
Should have known it would be a daylight engine. This is going to be a fun trip.
Hello? Let me just say, welcome to Fort Fairfax. Name's Luke, sister.
May. And don't call me sister.
Welcome to Fort Fairfax. My name is Dennis Bushman.
Nice to meet you, Beck. Name's Boston. Boston Rosen.
Right then. Perhaps we should get moving?
If you say so then. Just don't expect me to be any help at all. Okay, May. I'll lead since I know the way. Would you mind doing your share of the work?
Well, if I'm in the mood to do it.
What's that supposed to mean? But before May could answer, Luke was already moving out to the front of the train. Help me out! I can't pull you in the train alone! Damn, this is not good!
Dennis to Boston! Dennis to Boston! What's going on back there?
There's a throttle locked in place, Mac! I can't open it!
Looks like we're gonna have to work extra hard for this trip.
Dennis was right about that. With May not cooperating, Luke had to work extra hard while pulling both her and the bucket liner daylight. The extra weight was making him grow tiresome, and at each stop, he had to catch his breath. Sometimes, May would play tricks on Luke, like pushing him farther off the platform when arriving at a station. Finally, with a sigh of relief, Luke, May, and the train arrived at Salt Lake City. But I'm sorry to say that relief turned into disappointment for Luke once he realized that the train was 35 minutes late.
But I tell you, Mac, no help whatsoever.
Look, it was only one trip. Don't worry about it. We'll get her working again. We just need you and your crew to work together as a team. It's like my father always said, if you don't master the engine will master you.
Well, so far she's doing a pretty good job at it.
Trust me, Boston, there will be improvements.
I don't count on that for one bit, Mac.
Unfortunately, Boston was right. The next 2 weeks were passing, Christmas was around the corner, and there was still no improvement.
Boston tried his best, but he just couldn't get May to cooperate and help out on the train. Even Dennis tried his share at the tunnel, but still, there was no luck. It was on Christmas Eve, after arriving at Salt Lake City late, but the white flag was raised.
That's it, that's it, that's it! I've had enough with that good-for-nothing engine! All she's done is caused nothing but trouble!
Hey, that's my engine you're talking about, bucko!
Are you threatening me, Mr. Rosen?
Nah, I'm just gonna give you a knuckle sandwich and push you off the...
Alright, that's enough! Both of you need to calm down. You're acting like immature children.
Well, he started it.
What's that supposed to mean, you...
Thanks, Luke. We needed that. Anyways, Mr. Hanks is right. We've got one last run tonight, which needs to be on the dot. We're going to have to leave May here for tonight. After the holiday rush is done, then we'll try some freight with her. How about that?
Fine. Whatever it takes to keep her off this train. Now, if you'll excuse me, I gotta get that blasted ringing out my ear.
Hope you're happy, sis.
What the hell is the matter with you? Can't you just once prove your reliability to the railroad and put other people in front of you besides yourself? Why am I even talking to you? Back at Fort Fairfax Yard, Mr. Iverson was waiting impatiently. Eric's freight train was running late. 20 minutes. Giving me an explanation of why you are 20 minutes late?
Well, we kinda had a problem during the trip.
Problem? Okay, Mr. Brown, I'm all ears.
Well, you know the Grado de Muerto? That goddamn 2% grade at milepost 94? There's ice and snow on it. We couldn't get up the grade.
Did you even bother using your sander at all?
Yes, we were using so much sand that when we were waiting for the helper to show up, we had to refill the sander. If you still don't believe me, then ask Eric for yourself.
That won't be necessary. Take Eric to the service track and get his fire job for the evening and sign off.
Yes, sir.
City then. Back in Salt Lake, the Bucketliners crew was immediately at work getting ready for tonight's run. Normally, the train doesn't make evening trips. But because of the holiday rush, this was a special occasion. Everyone was running back and forth in preparation for the run. Even Boston was pitching in.
Thanks for helping us get Luke's service, Boston.
Don't sweat it, Matt. It's the least I can do. Especially for all the trouble you've caused.
Hey, don't listen to Mr. Hanks. We'll get May a proper engine and you a great engineer soon.
Matt, Why don't you just wave the surrender flag and give up?
Because I know you're a good engineer. And I do know that May is a good engine that can get the jobs done. Both you and her have the potentials, and can make a great team.
Excuse me, sir. Are you Mr. Washburn?
Yes, I am. Who are you?
Western Union. I have a master's degree from Fort Fairfax, California.
Ah, thank you. And Merry Christmas!
You too.
Alright, let's see what we got here. Uh-oh.
What is it?
Looks like the southern Utah area got hit with a blizzard a few hours ago. There was a freight train that tried to reach the Grado de Muerto on its own, but had to get a helper engine. And I think that's what we're gonna need.
Easier said than done, Dennis. All the engines here are either unavailable or shutting down for the night. There's no time to get one of them fired up.
Well, there is one engine that's still steamed.
Oh no! No way! Forget it! We are not going to use May!
Mr. Hanks, with the circumstances, we don't have a choice!
What makes you think May will actually help out?
Don't worry. Boston will make sure she will.
What?
Just give us 15 minutes to get her ready.
Fine. 15 minutes. But that's all you're getting.
Damn it, Max. You had to put me in this situation.
Come on, no time to waste. We gotta get May moving.
Okay, May. You don't like me, and right now you're not so good in my books. But we need your help. See, we need you as a helper engine with Luke to pull the bucket liner daylight.
How about no?
Come on! There's families on that train that need to go home for the holidays!
I don't care.
Okay, I'll make you a deal. If you help us pull that train to Fort Fairfax, you won't have to do any work at all. None. We won't bother you, and you can just sleep all the time.
All the time?
Why, of course. After all, 'tis the season.
There's no way she'll believe.
Okay, then. As soon as we get back to the yard, you won't bother me at all. You hear?
You got yourself a deal. Now then, are we gonna sit here and dwindle? Or are we gonna get down to business?
Right. Let's get going. We gotta get that train moving. Wait, Boston. How are you gonna explain that deal to Mr. Iverson?
Hey, don't worry about it, Mac. I'll take care of Mr. I. What's important is that we get this train going on time.
Good point.
So what did they do? Threaten you or something?
Actually, I just got an offer I couldn't refuse on.
Yeah, whatever. Look, are you fine up front?
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Just west of Fish Lake, the bucket liner daylight approached the 2% grade. Ice definitely covered the rails. Both May and Luke were starting to lose a small amount of traction, but no way that wasn't stopping them.
Alright, Mac. We're starting to make the climb.
Roger that, Boston. Just take it easy on the throttle and sander, and we'll be just fine. Over and out. Okay, Mark. Here we go.
Once they met the grade, their speed was starting to decrease, but with the sanders on and the throttles open, the train continued on. The snap talk from the two engines began to echo across the Utah Valley, with smoke rising to the sky. Speed. It had crested the grade! All right, Nate! Hey, Mac! We did it!
We sure did, Boston. From now on, it'll be smooth sailing back to Fort Fairfax.
You got it, Boston Act.
Boston, both you and May did a great job.
Thanks, Mac. It sure was a hell of a good ride.
We made it! With 5 minutes to spare. Well done, Mr. Bushman.
Thank you very much, Mr. Hanks.
You too, Mr. Rosen. Well done. Oh, and also, about what happened back at Salt Lake.
Hey, don't sweat it, Mac. What's important is we got this train here safely and on time, right on the tip.
Well, the train hasn't completed its run yet. So let me just say, have a Merry Christmas.
Thanks, Mr. Hanks. You too. And good luck with the rest of the journey to L.A.
Twas a cold winter's evening. The guests were all leaving. O'Reilly was closing the bar. When he turned and he said to the lady in red, get out, you can't stay where you are. Oh, she shed a sad tear in her bucket of beer. as she thought of the cold nights ahead, when a gentleman dapper stepped out of the bathroom, and these are the words that he said. Oh, her mother never told her all the things a young girl should know about those daylight railroad boys and how they come and go, mostly go. Oh, age had taken her beauty, and sin had left its sad scar. So remember your mother's and sister's boys, and let her sleep under the bar, under the bar.
Hey, you really put a lot of effort when we went up that grid.
A lot of effort? You must be slipping.
I just want to say thanks.
Don't mention it. And I mean to anyone.
Right, right. Merry Christmas.
How's it look, Nigel?
Pretty good, Dennis. No cracks, no broken pipes, nothing. Safe to say, you're done for tonight.
Good, good. All right, Mark, drop the fire.
Yes, Mr. Busher.
Well, Mac, got Mac's fire dropped.
That's good to hear.
Oh, before I forget, I just want to say thank you. I have to say, like I said before, that was probably the best run I ever did with her.
What did I tell you? Both you and May make a pretty good team.
I just heard about your run. I am very pleased with your performances. Especially you, Mr. Wilson. Looks like you're starting to make great improvement with May. I expect her to be pulling the bucket line in daylight all by herself by New Year's Eve.
Yeah. About that, Mac. You see here...
It's Mr. Iverson.
Okay then, Mr. Mac. As I was saying...
Oh dear. Looks like Mr. Iverson is gonna give Boston a good long tongue lashing.
I'm more worried that he'll do the same to me.
Well, lads, it's midnight. Merry Christmas.
Reach for the wind, reach for the whistle. Reach for the song, reach for the story, follow the rainbow sun. To a shining time station where dreams can come true, waiting there for you. So much to see, so far to travel, so much to learn to know. Friends by your side, hopes to hold on to, who knows how far we'll go. To a shining time station, where dreams can come true. Your own imagination's waiting there for you. Shining time station, where dreams can come true. Your own imagination's waiting there for you, waiting for you.